in coverage tonight. California taxpayers are on the hook for tens of thousands of dollars, all because of a problem with a company that provides uniforms for state maintenance workers. As KCRA3's Sharakina Shams found out, a failure to properly oversee the state contract has now turned into a big bill for the taxpayer.
You see them at the state capitol every day. Groundskeepers who often wear jeans, but state-supplied shirts. There are more than 800 of them working for the Department of General Services, and they take care of 40 state buildings. But those simple shirts, along with other uniforms, have just cost taxpayers tens of thousands of dollars more than usual. Why? Records obtained by KCRA3 show when DGS contracted with uniform rental company Aramark last summer, it had been months since the contract with the old company, Prudential, had expired. So the managers of all these buildings who would have been without uniforms for their workers refused to return the old ones to Prudential.
It's a product that we invest a lot of money into, and when that's not returned, then we do ask for that to be reimbursed to us.
Prudential requests payment.
So this week, Prudential went before the Victims Compensation and Claims Board and settled for $87,000 after its invoices to DGS had gone unpaid.
DGS manages all the state contracts.
We took the information to former State Senator George Runner, who now sits on the Board of Equalization, and says it could speak to a larger problem.
I think taxpayers want to know, is this unusual or is this something that happens often?
A spokesman for DGS says this was isolated, but the agency is making change.
And we've instituted tighter controls where this kind of thing is not going to happen again.
And this is a copy of those state contracts. It shows that taxpayers actually pay roughly $300,000 a year to have those state worker uniforms rented, picked up at all those buildings, taken away, laundered, and then delivered again. Live here in the KCRA3 HD newsroom, I'm Sharakina Shams, KCRA3 reports.
Sharakina, people may be thinking, okay, all that money for just rented uniforms, why doesn't the state just buy the uniforms and let the state employees wash them at home?
Well, Goldstein, it turns out that is because of a different contract, a labor union contract that requires the state to care for all those uniforms, maintain those uniforms, and yes, that includes cleaning them.
All right, Sharakina, thanks.